we go again. This can't be good. This will not be good. Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the stream. I'm your host, Just One Dad, here to share with you another daily dose of Dino Crisis. When I booted this up, I nearly shit myself because I went to memory card 1 to load my save data, as you do, and I discovered immediately that there was no data on the first memory card. I thought we were screwed, but it turns out everything was just switched over to memory card 2. So there's no fear, there's no cause for alarm. We are in position. Let me just adjust my mic. I've got my delicious agua fresca. And we're ready to get back in here and murder some dinos. Let's go to the old channel here. Let's take a little peek. All right, I think we're good. I think we're live. And all right, let's get to it. All right, as I recall, last time we're trying to do something, but I, for the life of me, cannot remember. Okay, looks like we gotta go into the research facility. Easy enough. I remember we were attacked by ninjas. Play this game. Clearly I have forgotten. What I do know is we always need hemostat. Dig the kind of law. Oop. Don't stop! fairly certain they do it. Oh no, the battery power of my controller is failing me. Going back to the save spot and repurchasing a bunch of equipment, clearly. I guess we'll just consider this farming. Without the facility key card, there's not a whole lot we can do here. I'm not sure why, where we get it. Unless I have it. I do have it. What the fuck? Got some good dosh. What's this for? It's a terminal to open and close the ventilation hole. Okay, yeah, alright. Well, we'll get this, let's go ahead and slash that open so we don't have to worry about that. And we'll go ahead and grab this key card. Researcher's records. The recovery of the time gate. Seems impossible with the limited instrumentations we have in this world. Today was supposed to have been the last hopeful experiment. However, the lack of instruments stopped us from conducting this experiment. 1 week ago, the transport team led by Lieutenant Wolf was supposed to bring us the instruments for the experiment. They never arrived. Something must have happened in the military facility. We still haven't been able to establish communication with them. If we still intend to pursue with the experiment, we need to go to the missile silo on the other side of the suspension bridge. But the bridge was destroyed in recent combat. The only other way to the other side is through the deadly poison zone. It is too dangerous to even go near the area. And a photo of a pre-rendered poisonous zone and bridge, presumably. Hey. I see eggs. I don't like that. It's a terminal. There's no power. There's no way to know what kind of data was stored here. See eggs. These dinosaurs built a nest here. Better not disturb it. Okay. Okay, and pack small. That's good. I'll take it. Let's close every vent we find. The cage is unlocked. Something. something inside the cage. You found a new dino file. Comps, Nagthus. Alright. Pretty jaws. Length, 1.2 meters. Height, 0.5 meters. Commonly known as a compy. Their diet consists of mainly insects. They are tiny dinosaurs. They are typically no threat to humans. They move in packs, and their social life revolves around their pack. So when they started nesting in our own research facilities, when they became a nuisance, their eyes appear to be similar to that of the birds. We speculate that when they detect small, shiny, metallic things, it is their behavior to take it back to their nest. This behavior has frequently caused problems inside our facility. No real notes have been taken since they do not directly inflict harm to humans. However, we are thinking of ways to stop them from stealing small belongings. Oh. Cool. However, as I recall, in Jurassic Park, as time went on, they definitely do become problematic. I think they ate a little girl in the opener of Lost World. Okay, cut those ions down, a new data disk. Let's see what's going on. Researcher's notebook, March 25th. Lately, many of our guys have been reported missing belongings, especially smaller items such as hand mirrors and watches. Just the other day, my silver rocket followed the same fate. There are rumors that it's the handiwork of a tiny dinosaur. It's got a real jivey name like Compy or something. Yep, a photograph of Compy. April 3rd. Today I heard an interesting story. Crows and other birds have a peculiar behavior collecting shiny things. It appears as though these Compies may have similar behaviors. Come to think of it, all the missing items were all shiny things. They seem to have a lot of similarities with the birds. It could be that they are their ancestors. We haven't been able to capture any of them since they are so quick on their feet. But if we use the behavior to our advantage, then maybe... April 6th. We used the cage used for laboratory animals, and we were finally able to capture one of them. We used Alan's bracelet as a bait and cornered him in. The key to capturing it is to block all possible escape routes. If there's even a small escape route, they will not enter the cage. Our plan is to use this cage to get rid of them as fast as we can. The raptors who eat them for snacks have started to roam around the area. Compies, what a nuisance. There's still 2 more weeks until the general research staff can move into Edward City. Until then, we have to do our best to protect this facility from the dinosaurs. Believe A. Well. Yep, we'll buy a hemostat. Yep, better make that too. And a med pack, M. Yeah, 3 rescue packs, so don't really need that. Alright, we technically have enough for the solid cannon. Fuck it. Inner suit. Heavy blade. Okay. I hope this wasn't a mistake. Alright. Let's try out the new gun. To the north and a door to the south. Door to the north just takes us back to the main area. Alright, well, good thing I do have the research facility key card.
Hey! That's mine!
Nice try, dipshit. I gotcha. fuck back here, you asshole. Rat bastard, get back here. How do I stop you? It's ridiculous. Fuck it. We're gonna roast him. Okay, so apparently it doesn't work either. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe I've gotta let it take it back to its nest or something stupid like that. Alright, so which way was... The nest room is the safe. Exactly one door so that he can get to the nest room. Alright, so I think with that, with him running into that room, hopefully my plan works. And he will just have taken the key card into a room in here. Advance to the next area. Sweet. All right. Got the starter battery and another data file, another dead body of a youth was carried in. As expected, he was not a resident of Edward City. If this really is true, then the only possible conclusion is that he and the others must have come from another time. Could such a thing be possible? These past months, youths about the age of 17 or 18 have shown up before us and attacked. Communication with these youths had not been successful, but rather been impossible. Alright, so they are time-traveling children, it would seem. Today we plan to remove one of the bodies out of the preservation liquid and conduct an autopsy. The result of the autopsy will be reported to the Colonel Mason. To Colonel Mason, who has dispatched the third energy facility. Well, I think that's it for what we need to do here. Is there mission details? I have no idea. Guess we're about to find out. I really don't like when they can just attack you from off screen. I've got it. Come on. There we go. stock ammunition. Cashola for that. That's a lot of fun. This is a fun weapon. Probably not the most versatile weapon in the game, but that little linger shot that it has is pretty handy. So what we want to do is go right, I think. I think. I'm actually not sure. Sad when it turns out I'm supposed to go the other way. What? Informed that my mic is low. I don't know if I can correct that easily. Only problem is I don't have Regina's sharpshooter gun. Alright, I've got that. I got volume up to max. Let's see, advanced audio properties. Left, right, balance, volume. All right, increasing volume by 125%. Hopefully that helps a little bit. Well, I knew it. I knew that this was going to be the wrong way, and yet I did it anyway. And now I'm going to be punished for it. Oh my god! This lightning gun is ridiculous. So for this one, gotta go down all the way and just up. Wow. And bleeding again. And I'm out of hemostat. Sound like Donkey Kong from the N64 days. Just horrific lizard monkey noises. Yeah, that thing is really stupidly powerful. Getting some of that dank dosh, though. Alright. Well. Time to blow all our money on items. Who needs rank? S rank? No thanks. Oh, actually, that's fun how much these cost. Wow. Whoa! It costs nothing! What? This is ridiculous! How does that gun cost no ammunition? Or no money to reload? So, dead air. E3 was this week. Still technically going on, it's almost over. But that was, a hoot and a half this year. Got some pretty interesting announcements. Some good releases coming out. Old Banjo's gonna be in Smash Brothers, that's pretty exciting, right? Dragon Quest rep, also gonna be there. New Zelda coming down the pipeline. Two of them, in fact. That Link's Awakening remake. All that stuff's looking pretty good. But, sadly enough, no Dino Crisis sequel. Sorry to the fans out there who were hoping. Big fucking just, I guess, Capcom just doesn't care about its fans, right? You know, they'll make a Resident Evil 2 remake, but they won't do Dino Crisis 2 remake. Or even a Dino Crisis 1 remake. Or even a Dino Crisis 1 remake. Wow, so that was so unfair. I mean, literally just flew in from off screen. That was ridiculous. Dylan, I'm sorry. That shouldn't have happened to you. No, but as a whole, I gotta say, you know, Nintendo had some interesting stuff being announced. Zelda's always exciting. Luigi's Mansion 3 looks absolutely amazing. But beyond that, pretty boring E3 overall. A lot of just not very many people had much to show. I mean, Ubisoft was a joke. EA was kind of a joke. Star Wars, Fallen Jedi, whatever, just looks like a worse God of War character action game. They don't stand a chance. Just meh is the feeling I get overall. Well, joke's on you. Well, the second I close this map, I'm doomed. Too bad. Alright, we're gonna be okay. Phew, alright. Oh, you gotta be fucking my asshole. Alright. Oh! He was right there the whole time. Oh, sort of. Whoa! Whoa! I don't like when they run. I don't like that. Holy shit.
Going to the cockpit.
She's gone.
Yeah, I can see that. You know what else is weird? I've checked the stats on all the residents and soldiers, but I couldn't find any profile fitting her description. It's like she doesn't exist.
Well, I was thinking, maybe she's not one of the survivors at all. What if those helmet people are from a completely different time than ours?
What?
Never mind. We found parts that might help fix the ship. But what matters now is we still haven't found any survivors or helpful data, so we must move on and search elsewhere.
This control panel is programmed to search for the areas where we can dock. Use it.
Right.
Dylan gave the battery to Regina. Alright, let's recharge the fuck gun. That only costs $1,000 to completely refill and kills all enemies in one hit. Edward City. Third energy facility. Alright, well. Don't actually know which one of these locations I'm at. Perhaps I'm in the red zone? Let's just go here.
Take care of this.
Alright. We have ourselves a little boss fight. Guess that means you better load up on the old... health packs here. I know we literally just saved not 2 minutes ago, but you know, I go on autopilot on this step. We're not. If there's ranks in this game, we said sayonara to that eons ago. No, not a rails shooter on a PlayStation 1 controller.
Also,
This map in the corner, I can't tell any of what's going on it. Did not control very well at all. And now we're Regina. Does Regina get access? No, she does not get access to the fuck gun. Alright, well. I suppose we can't all be winners. I assume this is where we want to be. What? I don't like any of what's happening here. This is a new area, new map. Alright, so, okay, it looks like a pretty small map. Watch. What is it? So I've never played this before, so I'm just guessing this is where I'm supposed to be. Regina, come on. Okay. Well, this looks like a boss zone area. Whoa! Favorite condition. Alright, data pack. Alright. This will be the key. It looks like this is the end for us. After surviving all this time, and to be killed by humans, who are they? These people with the full-face helmets and the rider suits. Somehow I managed to escape. but I seem to have dropped the key for this facility. How foolish of me. I can only think of one place where it might be. It must have dropped somewhere near the spring in the jungle. Wow. Wow. This spring has a rather fast current, considering its small size. I must go there quickly, or else it may drift away somewhere. The disc I was to deliver Colonel Mason has been stolen by them helmets. I believe the data was about some kind of autopsy. Alright, well, I'm assume this is where. Yeah. Oh, Regina. That's all she wrote, I think, for here. I don't see the other exit available right now, so I'm just gonna assume that we have to go now backtracking to the island to get the key. Which means. We almost made it to the room. We almost did it. These things seem extremely aggressive. So we were in the jungle. Now. Nice. So at least we don't have to do that every single time. So I think what we'll do is we'll see if we can't get that key here in the jungle, and we'll go back to the reactor facility, see if we can't get in there and see what's going on, and probably call it quits there for this game for tonight. I started a little bit late, and I tragically have work in the morning still. This is the room. Let's check that data file. think this is it. Oh, I see. Just gotta go with the flow here. This key card. Alright. Well, that was pretty painless. I think there's a whole area we haven't really been to yet. Yeah, so the missile silo, military facility, research facility. Cool, yeah. Nice to have kind of a 2-minute break here from just non-stop raptor combat. I'm gonna assume that you probably can't kind of sequence break that section and get that key early. Probably doesn't even show up until you find that data packet. I always think I'm gonna make it when I get through a room without getting hit by something. I'm disappointed every time. Damage. I did it again. Unbelievable. What's this thing? It's a box for putting small repair tools. Huh. So there's some weird fishing boat there. I don't have a key for that. Looks like just to continue forward. multiple. So powerful they can clip through the images on the screen. See a whole lot of merit to fighting most of the creatures here. Sweet. You got the key for the box. Alright, so that will probably get us into the boat. Another data pack here. Manager's diary. Mechanics, June 2nd, 10:30 p.m. Tomorrow afternoon, two mechanics are coming to this facility from Edward City. It is time for the annual maintenance check of the third energy reactor. This will be the ninth time. The instant something happens to the underwater reactor, that is when all lifelines will be cut off to us. Again, all we can do is pray that nothing will happen. As weird as it may sound, sometimes I feel that it'll do us all a favor if that reactor just blew up on us. That's pretty depressing. June 3rd, 4 o'clock p.m. The mechanics who went to the underwater third energy reactor still have not returned. They probably became their lunch. This is a problem. One of the mechanics, Bob, has a key to the entrance of Edward City. To go from this facility to the city, it is critical that we get the key. I guess there is no real choice but to get in a diving suit and go down myself. I just hope I don't become their dinner. Alright, I'm gonna bet we probably have a diving sequence coming up. To control terminal to check the operating status of the electrical generators. Generation of the facility. It appears as though they only have one generator to support the whole facility. Okay, yep. You need the mechanic's ID card. Oh. Wait, what? Oh. I don't want it. It's an ID card. You got the mechanic's ID card. This is ridiculous. I guess I'm gonna go downstairs, open up the boat locker, and then come back up, probably heal, save, and we'll go down there through the mechanics door. And I assume that's what this is. Yeah, key for box, that has to be what that is. Key item, key for the box. Data pack. Elevator security code. The security code for the elevator to the underwater third reactor has been changed. The code is 2350. why that code is being stored on some random boat. Sweet. I'm calling foul play if there's raptors down here. Has been shut to the elevator and to the diving suit.
Reactivating main power. Please check computer until power is supplied to all devices. Warning, when power is overloaded, this reactivation process will be suspended.
What? No. No, it can't be this. What do I give for just a standard puzzle? Packet. Mechanics note to Bob. I heard that you were placed in charge of this area. As a present for your new position, here is a memo which may come in handy. It's about restarting the power. We tried it. Yep. It's been more than a year since things were last used. Let's go diving.
Shut down. crocodile. Dig the suit. Whoa! Alright, I need to figure out what weapon I'm using. Sub-weapon. Shockwave. Okay. For these things too. Yeah, let's just do this part. We'll go a little bit longer. I have a feeling this probably won't be a very long section. Preventative maintenance. As always, we'll conduct the preventative maintenance by assigning labor tasks. Bob will be in charge of the third energy reactor itself. Alec will be in charge of checking the water circulation system. As in previous years, for the safety of the mechanics, during maintenance work, make sure to close the shutters for the cooling aqueducts. Alec will unplug the plug which allows control of the shutter and keep it until Bob is done checking the reactor. The other day, there was an explosion in the water circulation chamber. This explosion caused a crack in one of the concrete columns. One more explosion would have probably destroyed it. So we gotta go find the shutter control plug. Thank you.
you can jump.
Enough lift to get up there. Platform game. Man, I don't know what it is about PlayStation 1 3D, but there's something just kind of neat about it. It doesn't look good, but charming in a really weird way. Shockwave isn't enough. Thank you. purchase that has a little more firepower. Aqua grenade. Alright. That we can probably get whatever's in that room. Jump, and then even if more dinosaurs show up, should be okay. Cool. Weapon! Equip! Yep, I don't really need this again, game. Shortcut there we got now, and we can get whatever this guy's got. You got the plug. Cool, cool. That's probably good enough. I don't want to get caught in with like a boss fight or anything like that. So we will go back to the save room. We'll see what's going on with that other little elevator. If we can go down it, great. Otherwise, I assume we'll need the plug to... to get access to where we're going. But I have a pretty good idea of what we need to do. Thank you.
wrap this up. As always, thank you, folks, for tuning in. I know some of you were in and out. For anyone who's still out there, thank you very much for your time. Hope you have a wonderful rest of your Wednesday evening. We will be back soon, hopefully, to wrap this one up pretty quickly here. I've heard that this is not a very long game. So hopefully we have maybe one, two sessions top left on this one. But who knows? I feel like we didn't make too much progress on this session. So we'll just go ahead in here and we will just go ahead and buy that. So we're all revved up and ready. Go ahead and save. And that'll do it, folks. Thank you very much. Have a good evening. Until next time, see you later.